Hello, I am Flash Isaac. This is Flash Nenas. You are now watching 120 Days to Jam. This is a series containing 120 videos to prepare you for Jam. Each episode of the series contains introduction, outline, detailed class, questions, and homework for you. The questions and homework are from the Flash Learners Jam application. Install Flash Learners Jam app today to access all the free features. Click activate and scroll to buy activation key to get access to the golden features. Don't be scared, the app is affordable. Do you have trust issues? Simply chat me directly on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Telegram for installation and activation instruction. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to take off. This is episode 9 of the 120 Days to Jam Use of English with Flash Isaac. In this episode, we shall be taking a look at Jam Use of English Interpretation Questions. Sentences interpretation. Beautiful ones for that matter. Also, I shall be taking you through the hidden features of the Flash Learners Jam app. Enormous Jam Bytes. Numerous candidates already installed and activated the app. Many chatted me up on WhatsApp, while for others, they installed and activated on their own. Now, it is good to get the best use of the application. This is why I shall be showing you things you may not know are in the application. The ones you already know, no need to emphasize on them. The question we have today, the first question, says, the manager paid us in hard currency. The manager paid us in hard currency. What does it mean to be paid in hard currency? Option A, we are paid in foreign currency. If you say option A is correct, you are wrong. Option B, we were paid in dollars and pound sterling. If you say option B is correct, you are not correct. Option C, we were paid in a strong and stable currency. If you say option C is correct, you are correct. Option D, we were paid in new notes. That is wrong. Now, many persons believe that hard currency refers to foreign currency or just dollar. When they hear hard currency, they say we are talking about dollar. Well, dollar is one of the hard currencies we have, the US dollar. Hard currency refers to strong and stable currency. The currency that don't change easily, they don't fluctuate. They are standard currency. Examples of hard currencies are the US dollar, USD, the Canadian dollar, that should be CAD, Euro, the British pound sterling. These are hard currency. Now, we have other currencies that change up and down. They fluctuate. They are not stable. They are not strong. They don't carry power. A good example, Naira. Today, you hear that Naira has increased against dollar. Tomorrow, it has dropped. The value keeps going up and down. Now, the first hidden feature or feature that many persons don't use in the Flash Learners app is the practice by topics. Practice by topics. When you open the app, you choose any subject. You have option to choose a particular topic to study or to answer questions. For example, in English, if you want to answer questions only under sentence interpretation, you can choose only sentence interpretation and you answer only those questions. I am tired. I want to relax. Then I say, okay, let me answer this question, which says, if you were here, it could be more fun. This means dash. But question two. In this question, I don't want to be reading. I want to be hearing audio. So, I turned on the audio.
This means that option A, he was being expected to supply more fun. Option B, there was no fun because he was not present. Option C, he did not show up, so the occasion lacked much fun. Option D, he was expected.
You see? So you just relax. Read comprehension passages for you or read questions for you while you are in your piece. You are hearing, you are traveling, you are hearing questions, you are listening to questions without focusing or reading. If he were here, it could be more fun. That means that, look at it, when it comes to interpretation, don't look for a question that has half answer. Your answer should be the one that contains everything conveyed in the statement. If he were here, it simply means he wasn't around. It could be more fun. It means the occasion was fun. There was fun in the occasion. The occasion was good. They were all happy. They had fun. But if he was around, they would have more fun. That means there would be more or much fun. Much means a lot of something, more of something. So full of something. In summary, the occasion was good. There was fun. But if he was around, it would be more fun. A, he was being expected to supply more fun. Correct, but that cannot be our correct answer. A is a half answer. He was being expected to supply more fun. That answers the second part. It could be more fun answered. But how about the first part? That answer did not give us the first part. B, there was no fun because he was not present. That's wrong. There was fun. Just that it could be more. C, he did not show up, so the occasion lacked much fun. You see, he was not around, he did not show up. That part attended to. So the occasion lacked much fun. There was fun, but it wasn't so much. So this answers the second part. Therefore, option C makes a lot of sense to us. D, he was expected, but did not show off to make the occasion lively. He was expected, but did not show off to make the occasion lively. Look at it. He was expected, but did not show off. Up. Fine. Not bad. To make the occasion lively. The occasion was lively. Nowhere in the sentence said that the occasion wasn't lively. The occasion was lively. They had fun. But we just needed more fun. Not that it wasn't lively at all. So wrong interpretation, half interpretation is very, very wrong. Let's take a look at the next question that we have. Before then, one major feature of the Flash Learners Jam app is the Flash Learners Clara. It is a chat box. When you click on the box, chat, you can ask for many of ways. You can take a quiz from any subject. You'll just be enjoying yourself. It can tell you your jam subject combination. You can use Clara to solve math game, answer questions, play games. You'll just be saying, Clara, do this. During the last earthquake, Wadab lost everything but their lives. When you see but in a sentence, it is used to show contrast. They lost everything but, meaning they lost everything but they did not lose their life. So that contrast, everything was gone but life remained. A, they were alive but lost everything they had. B, they all died. C, they died but their belongings remained intact. D, they survived the earthquake alongside everything they had. A is correct. They were alive, but they lost everything that they had. Or, as far as Abu is concerned, Mero should be given 50 naira at most. Mero should be given 50 naira at most. School Finder. In the Flash Learners Jam app, you can choose any schools. You will see all the courses that they offer, their subject combination, whether they take accept two sittings or one sitting, everything you need to know about the school and their courses. That is a feature, and everything is offline. Then you have calculator to solve questions if it is required. Then you have the career guide. Okay, we'll get back to career guide. As far as Abu is concerned, Mero should be given 50 naira at the most. We have a lot of things to deal with. As far as, let's say, I am concerned, at most. In English, when we use at most, it indicates maximum. If I say I need at most 50 naira, it means 50 naira or less. Give me 50, I will accept. Give me 49, I will accept. 48, I'm okay. But I'm not expecting 51, 52, or anything above 50. If I say I need at least 50 naira, it means 50 naira is okay, 51 is okay, 52, above anything 50 or above is okay. But don't give me 49. So at least mean this is the minimum I want. At most mean this is the maximum I want. Now, as far as I am concerned, simply means in my opinion or in my estimation or to the best of my knowledge. Or the maximum I can give, the highest I can say about this is that. That is what it means. If I say as far as I'm concerned, you shouldn't go. It means, in my own opinion, in my estimation, to the best of my knowledge, or the best I can say is that you can't go. I'm not stressing you that you must do it or I'm putting it on my head. No. But I'm just saying, the best I can say is don't go. So, as far as Abu is concerned, Mero should be given 50 naira at the most. It means, in his own opinion, to the best of his knowledge, in his own estimation, Mero should be given 50 naira or less. Mero doesn't deserve more than 50 naira. Hey, in my opinion, Mero deserves 50 naira or probably more. More? No. B, all Abu is concerned with is that Mero should be given nothing more than 50 naira. Nothing more than 50 naira, okay? See, in Abu's estimation, Mero's merit not more than 50 naira. And D, all Abu is saying is that Mero probably deserves more than 50 naira or less. A and D are obviously wrong. Now, looking at B, the fact that the sentence says as far as Abu is concerned doesn't mean as far as Abu is concerned should repeat in the sentence. It doesn't mean concerned must repeat. As far as Abu is concerned, should be interpreted. Most times in interpretation, the words in the sentence should not repeat in the options. We have to interpret the sentence. As far as Abu is concerned, mean in Abu's estimation. Mero should be given 50 naira or at the most means Mero deserves not more than 50 naira. That makes option C the correct option. The Flashiness Career Guide helps you to choose career. You can choose, let's say you are going for electrical engineering. Type electrical engineering in the career guide. You will see where electrical engineers can work, their requirements, advantages of the course, everything you know about the course, and the things you should know, you should expect, how to prepare yourself for the course. So, it's so interesting. And the notification part gives you updates about JAMB and about my videos. Then, for any question, you can choose your time, an option whether to study. If you are studying, after every question you can check your answer, you will see the result. If you are using practice mode or mock mode, at the end of the class, at the end of the exam, you see your result and explanation. They are very interesting. And the last for today is I had dinner with Tony and Nick and they talk shop the whole time. Talk shop. Does it mean they talked when they were shopping or when they were eating? No. To talk shop means to talk about your job, to discuss about your work, especially with your colleagues or those who know about the job. So, during the time, they talked about their job. That is it. So, this brings us to the end of episode 9. For your assignment, get your Flashiness JAMB app and go through all these features. Try them out. If you have any problems, you know, chat me up or comment. I will guide you. So that is it. See you in episode number 10. And episode 10 should cover